everybody. Welcome to the main event on TBS. Tony Schiavone with the lady I still consider the first lady of WCW, Missy Hyatt. Two big main events for you. First of all, the Young Pistols will defend the U.S. Tag Team Belts against Big Josh and Ron Simmons a little bit later on in the hour. But our first match will be Sting, Marcus Alexander Bagwell, and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat against Beautiful Bobby, Stunning Steve Austin, and Ravishing Rick Rude. I gotta say about the Dangerous Alliance and Medusa a few things. First of all, on the Power Hour yesterday morning, some very derogatory things said about Medusa by Missy Hyatt.
Are you speaking about the Alpo remark?
Yes, about the Alpo remark. How do you get away with these things anyway?
I do because I'm Missy Hyatt. But you know, Medusa never talks. All she does is bark.
Fans, last week you saw Ravishing Rick Rude and the Rude Awakening on Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Let's take a look at a six-man return bout from what happened last week. Our first event on the main event.
Big six-man tag as we take a look at the Dangerous Alliance in their corner. Paulie is in there. Of course, Medusa in there with them. Bagwell, Sting, and Steamboat across the way. Good to have you here on TBS for the main event. And there's the feeling of many of the fans. Sting is still the champion. Well, in a mere 2 weeks, he'll get a chance to get that title once again. He and Lex Luger for the WCW World Heavyweight title. Super Brawl exclusively on pay-per-view. Little confidence builder in that corner. And you got to realize, even though it is legally 3-on-3 here, you got Paulie and Medusa, and it's not below them to get involved in this matchup. Fans, also some great information about World Championship Wrestling's next big event, and that is coming to the Omni on Sunday, March 8th at 7:30. We'll have more on that a little bit later on. Steamboat taking both members down. And that maneuver by Steamboat only served as a show of force here. And he did exactly what he wanted to do, and that was to get the Dangerous Alliance, quote-unquote, bent out of shape. Steamboat and Ravishing Rick Rude, and what a matchup they will have for that United States heavyweight title. Special stipulation we'll be talking about with Eric Bischoff in our WCW magazine coming up concerning that match. Full arm drag and twist. A rake to the face. And now to the hand. The power of Steamboat. And no one, as you take a look at Mike Atkins, the referee, no one can deny the power of Rick Rude either. Picks him up by that left arm. All that tension now is right on the forearm, so Rude turns around with his other forearm and nails Steamboat in the head. Steamboat returns fire with some of those karate chops of his. Oh, good move by Rude. And an equally good move by Steamboat. And a belly to back coming up, or is it? No, it's an atomic drop. And you can see that that was right on target on Rude. Arm drag takedown. For Steamboat to be successful against Rude, he is going to have to take the fight right to him. Fans, we've got some big news that the Omni has Sting and Steamboat in the main event against Ravishing Rick Rude and Stunning Steve Austin. That special grudge match will be the main event at the Omni Sunday, March 8th at 7:30. Plus a special challenge match, the Steiner Brothers against Arn Anderson and Beatable Bobby. Kick to the chest. And as you know, yesterday, a surprise right here on TBS as Greg Valentine appeared helping the TaylorMade Man. Greg Valentine will be on that big card of the Omni on Sunday, March 8th, we understand. Pick up, hard slam down. Bobby retreats to his corner, and that is an old Dangerous Alliance tactic. It's been so successful so many times, and that is when things are not going your way, your first retreat is to your corner, and Bagwell showing that he has come a long way in a short period of time, holding firmly away from the Dangerous Alliance corner. Bagwell from just north here of Atlanta and Sprayberry High School in Marietta. Underneath the legs, and he escaped again, and the arm drags Austin down. Stinger is in. Tremendous roar from the fans, and back goes Austin once again. Sign headlock. Shoulder block kick jab. The counter and elbow tie up. Over the top. Hip toss. And to the midsection. Tremendous double team that time. Dangerous Alliance looking sharp, but Sting with a clothesline of his own and another one. What a tremendous first event this week. Oh, Bobby goes down with a roundhouse right hand. This week here on the main event. Bobby holding on to Rude. They want him to stay back here. Now Sting right now is really on a roll, and this I would think is good advice. Fans are standing. They want Rude and Sting to go at it. We had a tremendous tag team event yesterday here on TBS, and we are going to have next Saturday with Jim Ross a tremendous eight-man tag event as a result of what happened. The Dangerous Alliance to meet Sting and Dustin Steamboat. And the reverse chin lock is applied as you take a look at Medusa. Also, fans want to remind you, Jesse the Body Ventura will be with us on the Power Hour next Saturday, 9:05 Eastern. Actually, this coming Saturday, whatever you'd like to say, but it's as we head towards Super Bowl, belly to back and a great execution that time by Austin. Clothesline. Tag is made, and Beatable Bobby comes in. Backbreaker on Steamboat. He only got a one count out of it. Elevation again, and a second backbreaker. There is no question as we head towards Super Brawl that they have been trying to work on the back and the neck of Steamboat. And there's a swinging neck breaker right there, and they go with a tremendous double team, basically. One man, then the other. Rude coming in, and now he's really unloading on the Dragon. Trying to make the tag. Sting is close. He's close to Bagwell. He made the tag. Stinger in. Wait a minute. Mike Atkins apparently was in the corner, didn't see the tag, and now a triple team ensues here. So the tag was not made. Well, actually it was, but it was not deemed legal. And it's still Rude and Steamboat. Big clubby move on the back of the head. Sting is really irate. A roll up! Bobby made the save. Referee was out there to make the count anyway. So tough to call a six-man or an eight-man tag match. We do understand from the Office of the World Championship Wrestling that some efforts are being made to try to neutralize Foley's effective ringside in some matches coming up in the month of March. Maybe in the latter stage of the month of February, we'll hopefully have some more information on that in the weeks to come. That time, Austin reeled on the right hand of Bagwell, but he nailed Steamboat as well. You don't see that every day. Both men now down again. Lance is screaming for Steamboat to get Sting in. He needs Sting or Bagwell. Here, he got Bagwell. Bagwell now. Trying to unload on the World TV champ. High elevation, the back body drop. And a clothesline takedown. Down goes Bobby. Here comes Roode. Down he goes. So Bagwell with a surge of adrenaline here. Power slap. And now everybody's in. Fans are loving this. Atkins ushering Steamboat out. Look at the pin. Right on top of the head. Bagwell obviously had the pin on Austin. And look at this.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the Dangerous Alliance of Beautiful Bobby, stunning Steve Austin, and ravishing Rick Rude.
Dangerous Alliance continues their onslaught. Wait a minute now. Nailing Bagwell with a chair for crying out loud. And an attack once again. Stinger is in. We'll be back on the main event.
The amazing Valentine for Greyhound half-price fares.
Greyhound's not the only one who can cut things in half. Say what?
Welcome back to TBS. I'm Eric Bischoff with this edition of WCW Magazine. With Super Brawl II, the giant pay-per-view exclusive from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, less than 2 weeks away, every athlete signed to compete on this card seems to have intensified their training in preparation for their individual contests. Now, yesterday on WCW, we discussed the fact that Ricky the Dragon Steamboat has retained the services of a masked ninja to prevent any attack from the Dangerous Alliance as the Dragon gets set to meet ravishing Rick Rude for the United States title. Now, here's how Steamboat introduced his ninja to his fans. Who is Team Jesse, the Body Ventura, regarding this matchup?
This is Jesse the Body Ventura telling you again, mark the day down, February the 29th, Super Brawl 2 on WCW, because the body is back, and the body will be broadcasting the Super Brawl from start to finish. My vocal cords are just getting warmed up. And a match that interests me immensely in the Super Brawl 2 is for the WCW Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. Jushin Liger, the champion, meeting the former champion, Flying Brian Pillman. You've got the only two people in history to hold this light heavyweight title in WCW going head to head. And believe me, when the light heavyweights get in the ring, they will be flying from pillar to post, up and down so fast, I'm gonna have to really get my vocal cords going just to keep up with it. So mark the day down, February 29th, Super Brawl 2, Jesse the Body.
Let's take a look at the lineup for Saturday, February 29th, exclusively on pay-per-view from Milwaukee.
The WCW World's Heavyweight title on the line as the total package Lex Luger faces the challenge of Sting. The United States Heavyweight title up for grabs, the challenger, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, going after ravishing Rick Rude. And defending the WCW World Light Heavyweight title, Jushin Thunder Liger will meet Flying Brian. The Steiner brothers going after Arn Anderson and Beautiful Bobby for the WCW World Tag Team titles. And in a special challenge match, The Natural, Dustin Rhodes, and Barry Windham going after Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko and Stunning Steve Austin. The Z-Man will meet Richard Morton. The All-American Ron Simmons going after Cactus Jack. Heavy Metal Van Hammer will face the Diamond Stud. The Rookie Sensation, Marcus Alexander Bagwell, will meet the TaylorMade Man. The Rapmaster PNU is going after Mr. Hughes. And an eight-man tag team action, El Gigante, Johnny B. Bad, Big Jackson, Mike Graham, will meet the Young Pistols, Vinny Vegas, and Diamond Dallas Page Super Brawl 2.
A program note, Jesse the Body Ventura will have more analysis this Saturday morning on the Power Hour, so be sure to tune in. Also, Jim Ross talks to Paul E. Dangerously and Ravishing Rick Rude about a very special stipulation that has been added to the United States title bout for Super Brawl 2. I'm Eric Bischoff for the WCW Magazine, and the main event continues with Tony Schiavone and Missy Hyatt right after these messages.
All the Supers!
Super Brawl 2!
Live and only on pay-per-view. Call your local cable operator for availability.
All right, PNU is the Rapmaster set to go in this event. Here on TBS, and our thanks to Eric Bischoff, the stipulation that he's describing was announced yesterday here on World Championship Wrestling, in which Paulie Dangerously will be barred from ringside in the Ravishing Ring. Fans immediately following this match, a clip from Columbia Pictures' Gladiator movie, a movie which you and 100 of your friends can win a free screening to. We'll see that at the conclusion of this match as PNU's the Rapmaster goes up on top. Set to go. And all the way down. And that is it.
All my posse and me. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo! Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo!
Here's the clip from the Gladiator.
Welcome back to the main event, everyone. This is Jim Ross with Paul E. Dangerously, the Executive Director of the Dangerous Alliance and the reigning United States Heavyweight Champion Ravishing Rick Rude. As you all know, at Super Brawl 2, exclusively on pay-per-view Saturday, February 29th, it will be Ricky the Dragon Steamboat challenging Ravishing Rick Rude for the United States Heavyweight Championship. And we've just found out this weekend that Paul E. Dangerously will be barred from ringside for that championship matchup. And before we talk to the champion, Paul, I'm sure you have some comments regarding this very unique stipulation.
You see, what this shows me is that World UCW would get afraid. We knew they'd stick something like this at us. And like every great contingency plan, we are fully prepared to implement it. Now, Steamboat, I don't know if you went begging to K. Allen Fryer. I don't know if WCW came to you with this conspiracy. But I'll assure you of one thing. At Super Brawl, Ravishing Rick Rude will make sure that it's the Dragon that will get burned.
Rick, with Paul E. absent from ringside, will this change your strategy as you prepare to meet the Dragon for the U.S. title?
Of course the strategy's going to have to change, Ross. But one thing that's not going to change is Ricky Steamboat's chances of becoming the United States champion. What it's all about, Jim Ross, it's about focus. And Ravishing Rick Rude is a focused athlete. I'm focused on Ricky Steamboat. I'm focused on the Super Brawl. And I'm focused on the United States Heavyweight Championship. Ricky Steamboat, are you focused? No. Ricky Steamboat, you can't be focused because you got an old lady who nags at you 24 hours a day. You got a little boy pulling on your britches, daddy this, daddy that. Super Brawl, Ricky Steamboat, you will be the object of Ravishing Rick Rude's focus. And when Super Brawl is come and gone, all you will be, Ricky Steamboat, besides a great family man, is a notch on the belt of the United States Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Fans, you can see it all exclusively on pay-per-view Saturday night, February 29th, Super Brawl 2. And the main event continues after this very brief timeout.
Rick, I just want to be friends.
Bad news.
Cookies and cream, Twix.
Good news.
Honey, your father and I have been asked to chaperone the dance.
Bad news.
Now there's cookies and cream between the chocolate and that great cookie crunch.
Good news.
Cookies and cream, Twix. Another one of life's great kicks, Twix.
Oh, yeah.
Wrestling fans all over the world are rushing to get the best wrestling merchandise anywhere. WCW merchandise, with not only the greatest selection of grappling memorabilia around, but made with the quality you've come to expect from the WCW. And now you can write or call to WCW merchandise and get a free catalog. So right now to WCW merchandise, P.O. Box 105-716, Atlanta, Georgia, 303-48-5716, or call 404-827-4607. Do it now.
The amazing Valentine for Greyhound Half Price Fares.
Greyhound's not the only one who can cut things in half. Say when.
Ta-da! As we come to you, Super...
What? What's this imitation of?
I don't know, what?
It's Medusa trying to beg to use Polly's phone so she can phone home. E.T.
Oh, Missy. Super Brawl is 2 weeks away, only on pay-per-view. Sting and Lex Luger for the world title. You know, I can't believe you get away with saying these things here on TBS. And if you can't believe she gets away with those things, what about what you say on the hotline every Sunday? My goodness.
Well, you know, it's like all my fans voted to get Polly barred from ringside at Super Brawl.
Okay.
All my fans call because they want the real scoops. And as a matter of fact, what's the stuff about Sting and Marcus Alexander Bagwell?
He's been training the youngster, Sting has.
Yeah, I bet. I know what's really going on.
You do?
Yeah. But I really can't tell you here. Call me on the hotline.
Fans, coming up, our big main event, U.S. Tag Title, the Pistols against Big Josh and Ron Simmons, when we return on TBS.
All the superstars of World Championship Wrestling are coming to an arena near you. Make sure you show up at the Memorial Auditorium in Greenville, South Carolina, Monday night, February 24th, so you can see Flyin' Brian. Art Anderson will be on the card at the Civic Auditorium Coliseum in Knoxville, Sunday afternoon, February 23rd. Bells.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is for the WCW United States Tag Team Championship. It is set for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first the challengers, first from Warner Robins, Georgia, weighing 200, and from the Northwoods, 275 pounds, Big Josh.
To my knowledge, this is only the second time these two men have teamed together, and they have agreed to go after the Young Pistols and the U.S. Tag Belts as we go back to Gary Capetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, they are the WCW United States Tag Team Champions from Wyoming, Steve Tracy, the Young Pistols.
The Young Pistols, they've developed that new attitude, but they've also developed quite a winning streak. And in this matchup, I really think that you're going to find, if the Pistols are successful, it's going to be teamwork. Because Ron Simmons and Big Josh, like we said, only their second time teaming together. The Pistols, on the other hand, a regular tag team, know each other quite well, a lot of confidence. They have made challenges to the Steiners, and they feel that the Steiners are their next step to moving right up the ladder in WCW. Interesting comments from Paulie Dangerously back on the Ross Report. As that's which Paulie is barred from ringside. Does he have a game plan? Does he have something up his sleeve? I think so, to be very honest with you. Only we'll find out at Super Brawl. On the inside. I want to remind you, Tickets for the next Omni event available at all Ticketmaster locations. The event is Sunday, March 8th at 7:30. Eight big matches on tap, including Dustin Rhodes, Cactus Jack, and many others. The counter and elbow tie of Andre kicked out. And Tracy taunting Simmons and calling out to the fans. Fans, we want to remind you, we talked about Jesse the Body Ventura. You saw his comments earlier on about Jushin Thunder Liger and Flying Brian during our magazine segment. He'll be with us on the Power Hour this coming Saturday at 9:05. Jesse will also join Jim Ross tonight on the Jim Ross Radio Show on News Talk Radio AM 750 WSB, starting at 9 o'clock Eastern. Be sure you call in. You can talk to Jim, talk to Jesse maybe. Both pistols go down from Ron Simmons. Simmons using that tremendous power to his advantage here. The pistols doing everything they can to stall for time. It would be well advised not to run directly at Ron Simmons. So many things he can do if he's just standing still. There's a headbutt.
Oh, no! No, 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 no!
Simmons, certainly one of the top superstars in World Championship Wrestling. As Ron Simmons now is down, and here comes Big Josh. Right hands at the head. Steve waiting on him, and Josh picked it up. Great elevation on the Gorilla Press Slam. Standing side headlock. Good elevation, and Josh waiting on him. The log roll from the posterior. Wheeling Tracy around. And now the log roll of Tracy, and Josh wasted too much time. Once again, it's teamwork here. Josh looking the other way. Steve was the legal man anyway, and he's back in. Fans trying to clap and cheer and rally behind Big Josh here. Foot to the chest. Head first. And now the pistol getting warm here. This match exclusively here on TBS in the main event for the U.S. heavyweight title. Simmons wanted to come in. Tremendous super kick that time from Tracy. The positioning of that move is so critical, and Tracy executes that move as well as anyone in the sport. Josh waiting on him though. And Josh with a drop kick of his own, showing tremendous leg strength. Tracy screaming for the disqualification, and in the interim now, we see Steven Simmons wants to come in. Over the top is Josh. He makes the tag, and here comes one of the top athletes of all time in this sport, Ron Simmons. Power slam out. Right hand to the face. Shoulder block. Both men go down. Simmons looking sharp as always here. Here's a man who was very close to being world heavyweight champion. Had his shot with Luger and was inches away from being the new world champion, and now looking to be the U.S. champion. But both double team on Ron in the corner. And now the choke. Man, you heard Eric Bischoff talk about Larry the Cruncher and Ricky Steamboat, one of our great matches next week here on the main event. Missy and I will be with you at the conclusion of this match. Talk about some more things coming up. Simmons is dazed. He's in trouble then. Steve sends him in. Sunset flip, yes or no, it is. Good execution. But no referee to be found. And the manipulation of the referee here by the pistols being very effective. It's happened a couple of times in this match. Tag, Tracy back in. Double axe handle.
How about you, American now?
Simmons trying to crawl to the corner. Rolls up. Tracy in again. Well, we have had two incidents in this match, both caused by the pistols where the referee was not there. Tracy got a two count. What a grueling matchup. The pistols, as vicious as we've ever seen them here. Reverse chin lock applied on Simmons. Arching the neck back, pulling on the chin. Ron Simmons, who has great reserve. Certainly one of the strongest athletes you'll ever want to find in this sport, if not the strongest in world championship wrestling. He has been one half of the world tag team champions, as you know. He and Butch Reed were world tag team champions. Teddy Long, their manager at that time, and they ruled tag team wrestling. And now, trying to regain the glory again. Elbow to the chest. Tag is made. Tracy is in. Steve is in. Double team on Simmons. Hits the corner. They're going to try double team move here. Great move. And now here comes Steve. Nobody home. One too many times. Simmons trying to get the tag to Big Josh. Steve is dazed also. He's going to try to cut him off, but can he? He cannot. And Josh is in. Down goes Tracy. Down goes Steve. Again and again.
Out. Hey, Ron!
In the corner, communication here now. The pistols hook. Ron with the spine buster. Northern exposure from Big Josh. One, two, we've got new champions.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners and now United States Tag Team Champions, the team of Big Josh and the All-American Ron Simmons.
Simmons adds another title to his collection of titles he has won here in WCW, and the first title for Big Josh. Tremendous event. Simmons with the spine buster. They are our Alka-Seltzer Plus Cold and Cough Medicine Tough Guys of the Week. There you see the Northern Exposure. Alka-Seltzer Plus, tough medicine for tough winter colds. And we'll be back.
Open sesame.
Hey, Joe, we're down to the last Butterfinger.
The last Butterfinger?
Simpson going deep.
Get a crispity, crunchity, peanut buttery burst in every bite of Butterfinger.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
The story continues. WCW Magazine, the official publication of World Championship Wrestling.
Awesome!
Not just a catalog, but page after page of everything you want in a magazine.
It's really big.
Hard-hitting features and inside information.
I can't believe they printed that.
And you can save 33% on your subscription.
Yo, subscribe today and save some pay.
On newsstands worldwide, it's WCW Magazine.
It's totally massive.
February 29th, Super Bowl 2!
best friends become bitter foes.
Super Brawl 2!
Live and only on pay-per-view. Call your local cable operator for availability.
It takes...
Congratulations to the new U.S. Tag Team Champions, Ron Simmons and Big Josh. First title ever for Big Josh in WCW. Quite an accomplishment. He's only been here for one... Am I boring you with this? For 1 year. Fans, next week, though, the work just begins for Ron Simmons. He'll be teaming with Barry Windham in a big grudge match. Barry looks for revenge on the Dangerous Alliance against Arn Anderson and Beautiful Bobby. Should be a big main event next week here on TBS.
Let's talk about Super Brawl.
Super Brawl, we will talk about Super Brawl. It's coming up in 2 weeks. Sting and Lex Luger, everybody's talking about it. Certainly the biggest event in the history of WCW.
There's only one question.
One question, let's get it out.
Is there going to be any, like, cows or troughs of water up there in Wisconsin?
Missy, you never know, because when you have that microphone in your hand and when you're sent out to report for us, you never know what's going to happen, you know?
Things that make you go,
Fans, we'll see you next week right here on TBS.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following. Clone, the essence of sports.